And shit just keeps getting worse and worse and worse and worse. Hello YouTube, this is Tikibomber here. I'm actually doing my own cover of one of two stories that came up in my Twitter feed as I was kind of recovering from a lot of things going on in my life. Manchester bombing. While it was really bad what happened at the concert, and I really do feel sorry for everybody who had went through that whole trauma, either because your children were there and you were not there, or because you were with them and had seen it firsthand, I do feel bad for the survivors. I do feel bad for the people who had died and the people who had lost their loved ones. There's people right now in the hospital still being stitched together, being identified, and possibly further investigated on other scenarios. That was a horrible event to have occurred to begin with. However, as sympathetic and bad that I feel for the victims, I do not feel any sympathy whatsoever for the people who sit there and try to say, but, support Sharia law, but, support Islam. This is an Islamophobic terror attack. Don't let these people know that this happened and is affecting our very fucking lives this instant. There's a problem with that. If Islam is this very much so peaceful religion that they claim to be, and that Sharia law is this very much so religious law that is accepting for everybody, why is it that both members who support Islam and Sharia law fly under the ISIS flag, encourage lying and destruction of other countries for non-Muslims? Why is it whenever people try to sit there and tell you that the group itself, Islam, is not the threat? And that is the truth. Islam is not the threat. It is ISIS, who are all Islam, who all support Sharia law, and all push to fight for world domination at this very moment. They're the ones being protected because they follow Islam. If you're against ISIS for these leftists like Chelsea Clinton, as an example, if you're against Islam, or if you're against ISIS, you're against Islam. And if you're against Islam, that makes you Islamophobic. I'm not an Islamophobic. I do not have an extreme fear of people who have Islam as their belief. No. I feel bad for all the victims. That's not going to change with me. I do not feel bad for the people who are being punched in the face trying to say that this terrorist attack was not under Islam's plan. As far as I can see it, the further along that people who worship and follow Islam supports and promotes ISIS, the more damage Islam is doing to the rest of the world. I do not blame the people in the Middle East terrified to step up and say, hey, this is some bullshit here. We need to stop ISIS. You know, you're terrified. I can understand that. What I don't get is these fucking retards like Chelsea Clinton, like Linda Sador, who will sit there and screech about how Sharia law is a feminist movement and how ISIS is the most perfect religion to follow if you're an SJW. If you're Antifa, you should be a Muslim. Linda Shador would not have a voice in the community under Sharia law. She is only allowed to have that voice because she lives in the United States. And because of her fucking voice and what it promotes and how it spreads, we now have problems that involve at least 24 innocent people at a concert, which is very much so questionable if this said concert was for children, or rather the fathers who had to stay out there and watch the children. That's story number one. Story number two, which I'm seeing absolute zero coverage for, and is again about ISIS and how ISIS is taking over the Philippines. They've currently took over a city, Marawi. There's no coverage of this whatsoever. Now, granted, Marawi is only about 200,000 population, but they are raising their black flags as they continue to fight and behead and control the city. They are killing everyone who they cannot deem to be Muslim. They had broken a city jail, like made it so the inmates could escape to help them destroy the city. And it's really, really sad that the only reliable source we have for this is 4chan, where an anonymous poster had gone and said they took over a city called Marawi, which is on the western part of the island Mindanao. It's kind of a big city with 200,000 population, but not so big in the Philippine standards. What happened was the military and police conducted a raid on a facility by the city where they suspected the Abu Sayyaf, those kidnapping and beheading tourists, leader Isnulin Haplinon, I cannot pronounce that name for the life of me, to be hiding. Apparently, there was a massive terrorist cell hiding there with him, and they called reinforcements while gun battles ensued. These reinforcements took a hospital and college hostages, beheading whoever couldn't prove they were Muslim, and broke a city jail, freeing plenty of inmates. In addition, they set fire to some churches. This is ISIS, the very terrorist organization that not only supports and believes, but follows Islam and Sharia law. The so-called religion of peace, having such an aggressive group of members attacking and killing people who were in hospitals, are being beheaded. This includes women. This includes children. This definitely includes the sick and the elder. They've taken over a college, which would include feminists and social justice warriors, who would probably normally be praising and preaching about how great Islam is and how supportive they are of Sharia law, right up to where their heads cut off. I don't think anybody in the Western world has Islamophobia. What I think it is people from the Middle East who are very prominent in raping and murdering and pillaging everybody. With that kind of set mind from the Middle East, has a Western phobia to the extreme that they're killing people. They're taking over a country. Sure, a lot of you would say, it's just the Philippines, nobody cares. Nobody cares enough to report it. Except for 4chan. You all should think about that. You all should think about how peaceful ISIS, the head of the Islamic State's groups in assault and battery, promotes their peaceful ways by beheading sick and elderly individuals. Children are being murdered simply because they're not Muslim. And I'm sick and tired of seeing and hearing the promotion of Sharia law and Islam in the Western world. So sick and tired of it to the point that I'm ready to start blocking people for promoting that garbage. Again, I have no problems with actual Islam members. I have no problems with the religion Islam itself. However, much like a dick, I don't want it shoved down my damn throat. Until next time, this is Tikibomber signing off. Peace.